Good morning, children. Now this is 9th class social studies, 15th lesson, children. Industrialization and social changes. So in the previous lesson also we discussed many points about how industrialization started in England and how industrialization flourished in Germany, and last how industrialization in France, etc. Actually, France condition is different than Germany and England. These three countries in European countries, that means your Europe continent. Okay, but we can find 70% industrialization in the beginning only in England, because many favorable conditions are there in England. I said in the previous lesson. Once again, I want to explain to you what are that one. First industrial revolution started between 1780 to 1850. So this was said by the English Arnold Toynbee. What that man? Arnold Toynbee. He said and he used the industrial revolution. Okay, here means industrial revolution means all production, that means the production abundantly produced by industries only. The workers worked in the industries and they produced a large amount of quantity. So that is happening. Okay, children. So what are the favorable conditions? For example, Britain. So Britain was recognized in the world, workshop of the world. What is that? Workshop of the world. Because the scientists, they invented many machines. So that machines they implemented to run the factories, that means to produce the goods in the factories. So that industry, that machines are useful for the production of the goods in the Britain. That is we find. Next one, what are the favorable condition? This is one of the favorable condition. Invention, machines by inventors, that means scientists. Next one is bankers, so they are willing to give loans to the two industries. So that is why they are, the investment amount is easily available from the banks. With this amount they started industries or production. Next to coal fields and iron fields also there. They developed, they extracted the coal and iron. Iron is important for any industry to produce the goods, machines, etc. Next one, coal for to generate energy. Coal also very important one. Next one, iron masters are there in that England. So that family is Abraham Darby family. So these Abraham Darby and remaining his son and his grandson, they developed how the melting of the iron and how to use this iron in different purpose in the industries, etc. Next one is cotton spinning. It is also developed in England. Okay. Next one, steam power also developed. Who developed this one? James Watt. So when he invented this steam power, James Watt, after some scientists are developed again this one in a proper manner. Next one, it leads to the running of railway. In that railways, passengers are moving or traveling. We are carrying from one place to another place abundant of goods from railways, etc. Okay, children. Next one, transportation. Even in transportation, also very favorable condition for the fast industrialization in England. For example, MacAdam, he laid roadways, pakka roads. What is that roads? Pakka roads, etc. Next one, workers, women and children position in that industrialization. I said already, the workers position initial stage in England, it was so harsh. They living in a harsh condition, slum areas. They lived in the nearest place of industries. Okay, but there were no proper drainage system. There were no drinking water facilities, even water facilities, etc. So that's why they had to work long hours in the industry. So that's why their lifespan reduced in some areas 21 years, in some areas 16 years, in some areas 19 years, etc. Okay, children. After the industrialist and the government also, they took the welfare programs towards these workers. Okay, children. They reduced the working hours, etc. They took many precautions because on those days many people died in the industrial areas between the machines. Okay, so accidents occur often. Okay, next one, the workers. Next, women and children position. Actually, women had to do works in the household chores and also they had to work in the industries. Long hours, they had to work long hours, but they are receiving low wages only. Okay, they must to bring the water from the pumps, etc. And they will feed the children, they will look after the children. Apart from this industrial work, okay, children. So that's why the women suffered a lot in the industrialization at the beginning stage. That means initial stage in England. Next, the children position very bad on those days because the children, so below 10 years onwards, so they will allowed to work in industrial areas. Actually, in that industry, so machines are working. Okay, so the children are small children. They are fit between the machines. So to clean the machines and also to remove the what is the wastage, etc. Okay, they had to stand and working long hours in that industry. So that's why they exhausted. Sometimes they will pluck their hair into the machines and they will killed or they died. Okay, children. So that was happening in almost to every year in the England industrial areas. Okay, children. Next one, we discussed in this lesson about Germany industrialization and France industrialization. Actually, Britain is advanced about industrialization. Why? Because these all favorable conditions are there. Apart from these all favorable conditions, Britain occupied many lands over Asia continent and also Africa continent. They plundered the wealth of the Asia continent countries and Africa continent countries. They took away the raw material from these Asia countries, Asian countries and African countries. After they finishing the good, again they will transport these finished good and they are selling and getting more profits, huge profits. So that's why they became very rich in the world. Okay, children. So that is one of the advantages. But here Germany condition is different. Even though Germany is in Europe continent, it started the colonies set up in Europe, Africa and Asia and also North America, South America countries. Okay, next one. Germany is better than France, children. Why? Because in Germany we can find many lands. So coal fields are there, iron and fields are there, workers are there. So that is why within a short period the industrialization developed in Germany, contrast to France. France belongs to it is rural based area. So that's why they produce farm products, that means food grains, etc. So that's why industrialization started late in France. Okay, children. So that is the industrialization and social changes of the in Europe, especially England and Germany, France. Okay, children. Now I want to show you some important pictures and some important matter in this lesson. You come to the page number 120, children. 190, children. So in this, what you can observe, who were the inventors? It is interesting to find out the individuals who brought about these changes. Few of them were trained scientists. Education is basic sciences like physics and chemistry was extremely limited until the late 19th century. Well after the technological inventions described above. Okay, children. Since the breakthrough did not require
a full knowledge of the laws of physics and chemistry on which they were based. Advances could be and were made by brilliant intuitive thinkers and persistent experiments. They were helped by the fact that England had certain features which other European countries did not. Dozens of scientific journals and published papers and scientific societies appeared in England between 1760 and 1800 children. Now look at here, interesting matter. There were a widespread thirst of knowledge even in the smaller towns. This was met by the activities of the Society of Arts, founded in 1754. Okay children, Society of the Arts, by traveling lectures or in coffee houses that multiplied through the 18th century children. Next, most inventions were more the product of determination, interest, curiosity, even luck. Okay children, determination, pattudala, interest, asakti, curiosity, that is also asakti, even luck, koncham adrushtam, then the application of scientific knowledge. Some inventors in the cotton industry like John Key and James Hargreaves were families with the skills of weaving and carpentry. Richard Arkwright, however, was a barber. Look at children, barber Richard Arkwright and wig maker Samuel Crompton was not technically skilled. Next one, and Edmund Cartwright studied literature, medicine and agriculture. Initially wished to become a clergyman. Who? Edmund Cartwright. He want to become clergyman, that means pastor garu, and knew little of mechanics. By contrast, in the areas of steam engines, Thomas Savery, an army officer, Thomas Newcomen, a blacksmith and locksmith, and James Watt, with a strong mechanical bent, all had some knowledge relevant to their inventions. The road builder John Metcalfe, who personally surveyed surfaces for roads and planned them, but he was blind, children. Look children, he was blind, but he surveyed the surface of the earth, but he built roadways. The canal builder James Brindley was almost illiterate, chadukoledu, with such poor spelling that he could never spell the word navigation. Samudrayanamu ante kuda teliyananta chadukoleni vyakti canals ni ante kalvalu tavinchadu, but he had tremendous power of memory, imagination and concentration. Look children, he was illiterate, but he had memory, imagination and concentration. Okay children, now once you look at the condition of child labors, I said about child labor in this lesson, how children suffered, how many people died, etc. The horrible condition of child labors is started in the evidence collected by a committee of British Parliament in 1816. The following information was collected from one time master of apprentices in a cotton mill. He was asked questions by the committee on the condition of child laborers in his factory. At what age were they taken? Those that came from London were from about 8 or 10 to 15. Up to what period were they apprenticed 1 and 20. What were the hours of work? From 5 o'clock in the morning till 8 at night. Look, children. Pruddunne 5 gantala nunchi sayantram 8 gantala varaku ratri. Were 15 hours in the day the regular hours of work? Yes. Prati roju 15 gantalu kashtapadali. When the works were stopped for the repair of the mill or for any want of cotton, did the children afterwards make up for the loss of the time? Yes. Did the children sit or stand to work? Stand. 15 gantalu ninchoni cheyali. The whole of their time? Yes. Were there any seats in the mill? None. I have found them frequently up the mill floors after the time they should have been in bed. Were any children injured by the machinery? Very frequently. Eppudu. Okay, children. So that is your lesson. Thank you.